Hi everyone, in this video, we will talk about Poisson regression. Count data is typically modeled using the Poisson family, and it uses a log link function. Log link means you are taking the log of the response variable. And the modeled response is actually the predicted log count. So if you think about the formula, it is log lambda I equals beta 0 plus beta 1 x. So on the right side, it is similar to a simple linear regression. If you have only one predictor, it will be two coefficients with one predictor. But on the left side, we are taking the log. So the log of the response values equals everything is the same on the right side. So when you have a value, when you have a fitted model, when you have a value for x, the predicted value is actually the predicted log count. So once you have the estimated log count, you can get the value for lambda by taking exponential of the right side. So like this. So this is Poisson distribution where you're using the log of the count values equals the combination of the predictors. Like if you have more predictors, you can actually add them into the model. Like this is x2 and you can add more. Some examples of Poisson regression. Think about the number of persons killed. Number of persons, so that's count data. And the number of people in line in front of you at the grocery store. Also, the number of awards earned by students at a high school. So for this example, we are going to use a data set to predict the number of awards earned by students using the type of program as well as the score in math. So we have two predictors. One is the type of the program, the other is the math scores. One thing I want to mention is about GLM. So in R, when you fit logistic regression, you know you use a function named as GLM, and you specify family equals binomial. And for Poisson regression, same thing. You want to use a GLM function and specify the family equals Poisson. And this is GLM is actually denoting for generalized linear models. So it includes logistic regression, Poisson regression, quasi-Poisson, negative binomial, etc. So there are actually so many distributions that falls under generalized linear models, which is GLM. Now we can actually open a new R script and we can start looking at an example about Poisson regression. So first of all, I want to import the dataset. I'm importing the dataset named as awards. And view of the data here. This x variable doesn't have any real meaning. ID number, number of awards, program, and math score. So those are all the variables we have. And once you import that data set, I often copy the line and paste it here. So next time you can just run this line to import the data set. And you can also use names function on this data set so that you can get the variable names down below. And first of all, I want to look at the data. So my question here is to predict the number of awards, which is count data, using program and math score. Or you can think of your initial problem is to predict the number of awards, and you are trying to build a model using the current data set. So you are not sure which variable, which predictor or predictors to use. And maybe we can explore the data first. So I want to aggregate the number of awards. Let me just copy the names here. I want to check the program differences on the number of awards, like check their mean values for this data that we just imported. So you can run that line, and you are seeing the average number of awards for academic program is 1, and it is very small for the other 2 programs. Or you can even check their standard deviation, like what's the variations of the number of programs. So you can get the values here. You can see that for academic program, the variations are much larger than the other 2. And you can even use library. Also use the ggplot2 package. Try to draw a plot, like a box plot, because showing the number of awards for different programs. So we can actually use data equals awards and then assign the aesthetic information. So X will be the program, Y will be the number of awards, like this. And then you can do geometric object box plot, and then you can run those 2 lines. And you can see this is the box plot showing us, like, it's wider. The box plot for academic is actually much wider than the other 2 programs. And also, like, there are much higher outliers for academic program. But you can also see the median is much higher for academic. So this is the box plot. You can also draw a scatter plot, like let the data equals awards and assign the aesthetic information to check how the math score is affecting the number of awards. And then you use the point, and then you can run those 2 lines. So this is for checking the other variable, how it is affecting the awards. This graph is hard to see because you can see mostly 0, a lot 1s, and then it spreads out. So maybe we can add color to the dots because we know we have 3 programs. Maybe we can get some useful information if we identify the programs. So I'm going to copy everything here, and within the aesthetic information, I'm going to assign color equals program. So let's run this. And from the dots, you can see, like, the more spread out dots are the academic program. And for blue and green, they are mainly 0 and 1s. And that's the information we are getting. So let's go ahead and try to build a Poisson regression. We start with GLM, and then we assign, let me type the syntax here. We assign y, the response variable, and tilde, the predictors, and then we assign the data set name, and then we assign family equals Poisson, just to make sure it is running the log response variable. So we are going to do our response variable, and then we have 1 predictor plus the other predictor, and our data set name is awards, and then we specify the link we are using, which is Poisson. So this is our GLM Poisson regression, and you can see the results are typed here, and we got all the coefficients estimated here. You are seeing the program general and vocational, which means the academic is used as the the base category. So all those values are actually a comparison to the base academic category. And this is our model. So if you name it as M1, and you can run a summary function on M1 so that you can see more detailed results about this model. And you can see we have the estimated coefficients, their standard errors, and the test, the z-test for each coefficient, like whether they're significant or not. And we also get AIC values and the deviance. So these are the model results.